love to tell the story. Isn't that a beautiful song? That's what it's all about. That's about everything we do for God and in the church. It's all about telling the story of God and His love. Well, praise the Lord. I'm glad you're here tonight. And I don't know what the problem is with this side. But this side looks pretty healthy. I'm just kidding you folks. There's just a few over here, but we're going to pray and fill up those empty spots, aren't we? Praise the Lord. So I know there's lots of people away traveling, and again, we want to be sure that we remember those who are away. Some left after church this morning. We just have loads of people going everywhere, and that's as it should be, I guess, in the spring and in the summer. I was thinking today that I used to hear somebody say the hazy, lazy days of summer. How many remember those days? How many get time to be lazy? That's what I thought. These are days when you don't get much time to do that. Well, we thank the Lord for the opportunity to be with you tonight. And all through the service, the message the Lord has given me has been emphasized. And I just, for a few moments tonight, want to share with you the importance and why it is important that we have a song in our heart. And I've heard that all evening. We've sung about it. I've heard testimonies about it. And I love humming. I'll sing stuff that I've never heard before. Have you ever sung something you never heard? Anybody ever done that? Sure you do. Everybody. Well, not everybody, but I'm bad about that. I'll start a tune and even put words to it. And I'll just be singing along, and I don't know what I'm singing, and I never know what key I'm in. I never do, because I don't know how to read music. But I'll be humming along, and the harder I hum and sing, the harder I work. I love to hum when I'm working and sing. And you know, I think the Lord puts that in your heart. He puts a song in your heart. He gives you something to be happy about. And Christians, some of you folks are looking at me like, man, I never heard that before. But, you know, we need to be happy in the Lord. Amen. Amen. Something to sing and shout about. For we're saved by the blood of Jesus. We're redeemed by the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. What a wonderful opportunity it is to be in church tonight and just talk about it, if not sing about it. Now, I'm sure if I were to ask you tonight how many people have something to be sad about, you would give me all of you could tell me something tonight about something that would make you sad. But folks, sadness will always be there. You're never going to get rid of it. But it's the unique people that learn what it is to be happy in the midst of it. How many can say amen? That it can have a song in our heart in the midst of all the adverse things that happen. Well, it's good to be with you. I want you to turn with me tonight to the book of Job. Now, this is an unlikely book for us to be talking about a song in our heart. It's not because it's not a good book. It's not because it's one of the most powerful messages recorded in the Bible. But it's because the whole book is filled with seemingly adversity against God's people. Job chapter 35 and verse 10. Now I want you to find that, and I want you to sort of hold it. We're going to go over to the New Testament and read a very familiar portion of Scripture to you. Two verses out of Acts chapter 16. Acts chapter 16. Verses 25 and 26. Let's read Acts 16, 25 and 26. And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God. And the prisoners heard them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken. And immediately all the doors were opened, and everyone's bands were loosed. Now, if you're taking any notes tonight, if you're not, try to put it away in your heart. Every place, not every place, but the majority of the places in the Bible where people sang, first, those songs were preceded by hardship. Times when people went through hard places. When, in this case, Paul and Silas were in prison. Now, folks, you got to remember something. We can easily take this lightly. Well, we've heard this over the years. Paul and Silas was in prison. I've even envisioned plastered walls with lighting in the prison and a TV in the corner. And you know how it is maybe today in some places. But I'll tell you something. When Paul and Silas was put in prison this time, their sentence was death. They were never going to come out. They were put in prison for preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ and going against the command of the high priest and against the church of that day. But the Bible says, in their stocks and in their chains, as they were imprisoned at midnight, they begin to sing praises unto God. They begin to praise the Lord. Adversity has a way of filling the Christian with something to praise the Lord about. I find it all through the history of the Bible. And I'm telling you something today, in this age in which we live, I believe there are more things happening in the lives of people today than ever before. I'm talking about adverse things. Things that bring pressure. Things that bring turmoil. Things that bring worry to our lives. But I'm telling you, folks, we can go two routes. We can either live in that worry, or we can have a song in our heart. Amen. I know it's not that easy. You say, Pastor, it's not that easy. If you were going through what I'm going through, then you wouldn't be singing. But I'll tell you something, folks, the greatest song ever sung is the song that is sung when nobody else can sing. I want you to remember that. That's a Tomlinson statement. It's not, I didn't get that out of a book. I believe it deep in my heart. If I'm in the middle of 5,000 people, nobody appreciates my voice. Nobody. I can sing to the top of my lungs, and nobody even knows I'm around. But if everybody stays still and I'm allowed to go to the platform and sing like Sister Mary did, I thank her for that beautiful song. How many can say amen? Amen. And I'll tell you why she sang tonight, because I asked her. I wanted to hear her sing. And I'll tell you something, folks, if everybody keeps still, not tonight, because we're going to sing a little bit. But if everybody keeps still and lets me get on the platform and sing, maybe somebody and all those people will appreciate hearing my voice. I want you to know something. The heaven of heavens hears your song more vividly when everybody around you's in the ditch and nobody has a song in their heart. If a Christian will stand up in the midst of that crowd and sing the songs of Zion, somebody will hear the victory. That's exactly what I'm talking about tonight. You have a song in your heart? Oh, yeah, Pastor. How long has it been since you sang it? There's a song in our hymn book. And you want to follow? I'm not going to sing it tonight.